almost in here. Oops, that one. Let's go ahead and get the heads done. There we go, thank you. Alright, those can sit out. Let us take a drink. Get rid of some of this paint as well. So suppose we presumed that this was dry. And having thought that, decided we could go ahead and hit the back. So having been so presumptuous, feels like we're gonna need to pull in a bigger brush as well. But before doing that, we're gonna hit this edge. That one as well. Yeah, that can go there. You rest up there. I'm gonna work on you. But that means we need the small one again. sure we got all sides of this. It's not as nice as the top base, but that shall suffice. Now, I suppose it is time Torque Han. Spine Fists for some of the Termagants. Because I don't really want to work on the red. Which I believe is one part purple. Two parts brown. At least that's what I have it recorded as. And one part mixing white. That felt a bit wrong. So let's go ahead and peel this off. I'm glad I added a little bit of extra to that by accident. Probably should have given this a shake as well. And said that, clean the fingers. Come on. Thank you. Want matte, so we'll add 3 drops of that. Mix you all up nice and nice like. should be good. Let's take our detailing brush. Clean you all off. Go ahead and check out the purple in the other hoof first. Alright, you can go ahead and sit in here, seeing as we're not doing anything with you. Out a couple of iterations. I want to see which one actually is purple. There's my other one. Might be along the lines of two parts purple, one part brown, or one part brown, one part purple. Could very easily have that mixed up. So what we're going to do, let's finish coating this up, let it dry. And compare it to that guy. So I suppose we're back on red. So seeing as that's the case, to the termagants. Yeah. That's at half. Looking pretty nice. It's a bit thin. We'll see how it dries, but it feels a bit thin. Let's see. Doesn't feel that wet. Oh, those are gone. Let's take a look here now. Unpainted one. Yep, that's not the right color. Looks like it might be 1-to-1 on purple. So we'll have to update that code for you. Oops. Oh, went out a lot faster than expected. At least we only got one drop in there. That means we'll also need another drop of the mixing white. Should make it a lot more vibrant. Nope. Let's try this one out. Yeah, that looks better already. Set huff. Let's get this huff in. Don't forget about these little claws on the back of the feet either. Claws now? These was actually mid claws. This guy may be even considered main claws. Maybe we should zoom in right there, actually. Let's go ahead and do that. Autofocus. And that thing. have set our own closet on. You can sit back. Which means we can work on spine fists. Get a pair of these done. Oh, that's what we forgot. Oh, we didn't forget, but we need a little bit more. It's still a little bit thick. We're gonna hold off on the spine fists now that I've started doing one. Just so that way we can go ahead and get rid of some of that orangey-ness. Cause that is too orangey. Good. my dear. Just about the point where we are ready to varnish you. There we go. I broke that. Quite a few layers there, so we want to put it on a little bit thick. To check that out later, because I can't really see on you. I've got your arms on, so we can go to you. four claws there, done. Touch that. Across the back here. And then we gotta hit the teeth. Those three are pretty good. Not that it needs to get done, but I find it easier to do it like this. I will gladly settle for just the base coat. With these, because they're easier to get to, but got them off, so we might as well do them. Three and four. That was a horrible accident. Let's see if we can clean up some of that before it gets everywhere. We'll let that sit. Come back to the prime. Wanted to go ahead and get these onto the purple. That's that side. That's that one as well. So that's that. Now we can come over and get these ones. Now what I think I want to do, let's go ahead and get this stuck onto a base. So we're gonna flip it upside down. Have that brush sit there. Over here for our box of bases. These ones are going to have to come home to get primed. I think that one's the last unprimed one. Yep, that's the last unprimed one. Take the light white pile here. Let's play. I think we should be taking the heavier white pile. Now that I've started doing that. On the lightweight side. So mostly clean base there. Go. Now to glue. Which means where do we want him? Okay, so we got slightly different legs here. which leg do we want to be the primary leg? Comes the question. I thought I had the right legs all set up. So let's toss these in here. That way they're out of the way. You can bring them home, get them all situated. Alright, so I think we're putting this one as the primary. You're right about there. And we'll let you sit for a little bit, see if we need to pull you off again. I definitely would like more support. I'm gonna have to look and see if these guys line up. Okay, I think I'm gonna get these ones screwed up as well. So I think I'm gonna have to bring out my other Tyranid box, or my other warrior box, to figure out which ones go with which ones for next time. Having said that, I'm not too disappointed with this. And we can go ahead and start getting this one done. While we wait, because we're being real gentle here. let's see if we can get underneath this one. I'd really like to, let's probably super glue that tip. Just right there. But we're gonna let that sit there for a while. Super heavy. A lot heavier than I actually wanted. We are sorry for going all over the place tonight. Normally we have a game plan down on what we actually want to get done. But I've had allergies all week. I haven't been paying attention to anything. That one's been done there. You might stay on there. Actually, I'm not gonna paint that guy. What I am gonna do is say thank you for joining us, anyone who showed up. If you've got anything to say, feel free to send a message.